think the best way to prove your value is to work, is to learn, is to absorb, to be a sponge. But you always want to outwork your potential. As hard as you believe you can work harder than that. And that's what I tried to do when I first came in the league. But, you know, basketball is such a direct competition sport that me coming in at 17, I hated when, like, my teammates would say, you know, I get hit with an elbow, right? Shaq would hit me with an elbow in practice. And, like, you know, you know, Nick Van Exel would come up and say, are you okay? I'm like, what? Wow, are you okay? What the hell's wrong with you? You know, so like I always had that extra chip on my shoulder. So like every day in practice for me was really trying to annihilate everybody that I was playing against. Because I wanted to prove you don't need to babysit me. Like I'm fine, you know? And so it's always that competitive nature, the work ethic, and curiosity. Because I asked a lot of questions. When playing with Byron Scott, I asked him a lot of questions. Eddie Jones, who was great at chasing guards off the screens, and I didn't understand how to do that. I would sit with him before practice, after practice. Magic, all the Laker greats, I would always sit down and just ask him questions about certain games that I studied growing up. What actually happened there? What did you feel there? Why?
We were playing against the Lakers, Tom, and we were out here in LA. So the game was at 7. It's like, you know what? I'm gonna come to the Staples Center because we're playing. This one, the Lakers had Kobe and Shaq. Okay, this is like the championship Lakers. So you know, I'm gonna get there at 3 o'clock. I want to make sure I make 400 made shots before I go back into the room, and then I sit in the sauna and I get ready for the game. So, you know, get in the car, get to the gym, get there, and as I'm walking onto the court, who do I see? I see Kobe Bryant already working out. So once I set my foot across that line, I start working out. And so I worked out for a good hour and a half. And when I came off, after I was done, I sat down, and of course, I still heard the ball bouncing. I looked down, I'm like, this guy's still working out. He was working out for like, it looks like he was in a dead sweat when I got here. Right. And he's still going. And it's not like his moves are nonchalant or lazy. He's doing like game moves, right. You know? I sit there and I unlace my shoes. I'm like, I want to see how long this goes. So I sit out there and watch, another 25 minutes. And they got done. I said, okay, I think I've seen enough. Go play, you know, come back, get in the sauna, get ready for the game. That game, he drops 40 on us, okay? And after the game is over, I'm like, I have to ask this guy. Like, I have to understand, like, why he works like that.
Right.
So after the game is over, I'm like, hey, Kobe, like, why were you in the gym for so long? He's like, because I saw you come in. And I wanted you to know that it doesn't matter how hard you work, that I'm willing to work harder than you.